Welcome to Tales from the Crypt.
Hey babies, welcome back to my channel. No, you haven't put Shudder on by mistake. This is not the Crypt Keeper. This is the Booby Queen. Quite literally, like I do not have a bra on today. Like, one nipple is already excited to see you, and if you get to see the other one, I don't know what to say to you. Happy birthday, I guess. Today I've got a get ready with me. I haven't done one of these for a little while. No, actually I have, that's a lie. I was really hoping this would be a first post-lockdown night out get ready with me. Things aren't where we thought they would be, so no post-lockdown night out for me just yet. I mean, in a few days, but not today, like it was supposed to be. So I've got my table, I've got my old mirror that I will not throw away because it's all fateful. I'm gonna do my little blush nose because loads of you have asked for how I do that, and it's so freaking easy. So easy, so I expect you all to have your little blushed noses after this video. First things first, I'm gonna cleanse my face with Primark cotton pads and micellar water. I haven't spoken about it in a video yet, but I have vlogged it, and it's been edited, and it's in my secret YouTube folder of videos that just haven't gone up yet. But you may notice that I have my nose pierced, yay! So this video I'm gonna get edited and uploaded as soon as possible because it's got all the updates in it. But I do have a few videos that are gonna go up before, ooh, dropped it on the floor. It's fine, 5 second rule. Can't be any dirtier than what my face is gonna put on it anyway. So I have a few videos that have to go up first just because they've been sat in my little secret YouTube folder since February. So my videos are gonna flick between nose piercings, no nose piercing. But I did vlog it all, and my friends came with me, and one friend got her nose pierced and my other friend got double lips. Oh my god, she looks amazing. So keep an eye out for that. Not only have I had my nose pierced, and it's a long story about my nose because this is literally like the 20th time I've had my nose pierced. Oh, it's such a kerfuffle. I got a new tattoo, which won't be on a vlog. I do have a tattoo vlog to come, but it won't be this one. Okay, it's very dry. I got a little candle. I did TikTok it, and Elf 16 hour camo concealer matte finish. It was actually you guys that recommended this, and I love you so much because this is the best concealer ever, and it was like £6. It is so thick. Like, most days I don't bother with foundation, I just use this because it is so thick. I'm gonna do foundation today though, just to show you. Shove it everywhere, all over my eyebrows because I don't have eyebrows. Cover up that spot, mustache, cover it all! Yeah, so the tattoo I got was from a gumball machine at the tattooist that I work in one day a week. You pay £30 and you just get a random tattoo. Now, I am so in love with this idea. I think it's so cute. Like, I'm a sucker for, though I hate surprises, I am a sucker for a random thing, like going into a tattooist and getting a random tattoo. I'm a sucker for that. So I didn't vlog it because it was completely impulse, but I did TikTok it. So head to TikTok at Emily Boo Boo and you can see that. I was quite proud of that video. It literally took me all day to edit. TikTok confuses me. What else? So a couple of weeks ago, if you're on my Patreon, you already know this because you guys are my faves. It was Violet's birthday. She is now 7. And we couldn't do what we had to, right, so let me rewind. Literally rewind. So for Violet's birthday, we originally were taking her to a rave. I'm not even joking, a literal children's rave. It's a real rave without the kit. They had Artful Dodger and DJ Luck and MC Neat, Craig David. Because lockdown got extended, it got put back. So we are still going, and Violet doesn't know, she had no idea. So that's now on Bank Holiday Monday in August. So that vlog will be coming up. I'm just so freaking excited for that. Foundation, Body Shop, Bora Bora. So we went bowling. Oh, my friend got a surprise party for Violet at a place called Pernickety Pot. And you just make, like, it's a ceramics place and you go and paint ceramics. And she painted a dinosaur and I did a lion. Violet had a mug and a dinosaur. Yeah, it was so lovely. I've never been there before, but it was a perfect place to go if you've got kids. You just go and paint some pots. And it was really nice. And I've actually just remembered, because I haven't gone to pick them up yet. So you have to leave them for a week and they killed them.
Get into the kiln.
And then you go back and pick it up. And I completely forgot. I've only just remembered, so I better go and pick that up tomorrow. But that's it. So Violet is now 7. And she's nearly taller than me. That's not even a joke, she actually is nearly taller than me. So on the note of Violet Pilot, it is now school holidays, meaning that I have, once again, less time to film, less time to edit. But luckily I have videos already ready to go, and I really wanted to be doing 2 videos a week by now. But, I mean, I'm kind of there. I technically could. Until I've got enough to do 2 videos a week till September, and then that's with me not filming anything throughout the school holidays. But then when September comes, I would have absolutely nothing, and then I would panic. So I'm still trying to edit and I'm still trying to film. It's very difficult. Like, it's like lockdown all over again. How did we do anything in lockdown? I need a wipe. I don't know how people homeschool their kids and work from home, because you guys deserve a medal. Technic Superfine translucent pad. Oh, I've only used it like 3 times and I can already see the pan. That's great. So I shaved my fringe off a little while ago, didn't I? Because I bleached it and it, watch my piercings. So I have to put my makeup down the center of my nose and not on my piercings, because they're still healing. So you might notice that throughout my videos where I have my nose piercings, I have little red circles around them. Because I'm not risking them getting infected. So yeah, I bleached my fringe, and my fringe has been like the bane of my life. And it's finally at a length. It's kind of like that long. You can see it there. And I'm growing my sides back as well. And I'm going to be bleaching them in a couple of days. So my hair at the minute is green fringe and long and black. I'll show you when I put my wig on. I'll show you. So NYX Matte Liquid Liner. This is my favourite liquid eyeliner ever. It's what I do my eyebrows with. I was going to do cross brows today. Should I do cross brows or normal brows? Or both? Always both. Day of uploading this, it will be Tuesday, and we are going to Manchester on Saturday. The idea was that Saturday we'll be having a night out at Satan's Hollow in Manchester, and Sunday would, oh, what have I done? And Sunday would be a nice chill in the park in Piccadilly Gardens. This is when we naively thought that Corona would be we thought it'd be a lot safer. I'm not saying we are scientists or we are smart. I'm saying we were naive. We wanted a night out, and unfortunately, like, hope just got in the way of realisticness. So we were expecting and hoping that this weekend we would have a back to normal night out and day in the park in Manchester. But as Corona cases are still prevalent, they are still on the rise, we no longer want to encourage people to come to Manchester for our meetup. We are going to Manchester still because we are going to see our friends. Old Boris said it's safe. He says we're allowed to travel. We've been double vaxxed. We're okay. So we are going to Saturday at Satan's Hollow anyway. And then Sunday was our Piccadilly meet. Now, we are not encouraging people to come to that anymore. If you already have tickets, like train tickets and hotel or whatever, and it's completely non-refundable, and you're gonna be walking around Manchester for the day anyway, the Sunday we will be walking around, and just pop me a message and you can come and hang out. But it will be mask wearing and it will be away from me. I don't wanna get sick. I got a bloodstock in 2 weeks. On that note, bloodstock. Oh, that went up, didn't it? Story of my life. So Bloodstock Metal Festival is in like 2-3 weeks now, and I'm so excited. I'm going with my friends Anna and Kurt and Richard. It's so hard to do makeup when you wear glasses because I can't see what I'm doing. That's my excuse and I'm sticking to it. And we're all going to wear wedding dresses. We've all got wedding dresses. I'm still waiting for mine to come because I've gone through like 4 wedding dresses. This is not even a joke. I have literally bought 4 wedding dresses. I get them cheap off eBay. If you go on eBay, they're like a few pounds. because it's mainly charity shops, ones that get donated to charity shops, and then they sell them on eBay. So I bought loads and they don't fit. There's something about when no one told me that wedding dresses are like smaller than the advertised size. So I'm a UK size 12 and the new dress I bought is that I'm waiting to come is like a 16. And I swear to God, if that doesn't fit, I'm gonna give up on this wedding dress dream. So at the minute, I have loads of wedding dresses listed on my eBay just to get rid of the ones that don't fit. And the money's going back to charity, so. Yeah, so if you're going to Bloodstock, keep an eye out for us. We'll be in our wedding dresses. I do have a Bloodstock lookbook coming up. Hopefully either this week or next week. I'm not sure, whenever I get it edited. We do also have a meetup at Bloodstock the Thursday at 1 o'clock. I don't know where. I have an events page. I'll pop it in the description below if you want to come and hang out. Let's go do some bumper cars together. Let's watch some bands. Now that I've done my Skin Dread Benji video, my friend messaged me this morning actually and she was like, I hope you know for Skin Dread, I'm going to put you on my shoulders and I'm going to make sure Benji sees you. I'm like, yeah, he does like so many interviews, Anna. He will not remember me. I'm so excited to see them. At least I feel like Benji and I are friends now. I mean, I know how he wipes his ass. I know if he pees in the shower. I mean, you do if you watch my video. So we're best mates. We're Benzy mates now. BFFs. But Bloodstock, I'm so looking forward to. What else? What else? It's a sound like our police. Look, all my dirty brushes. Why do I not learn? That's my favorite brush. We use that one. This is my favorite palette in the whole world. It's the Jolie Sorceress palette. If I was to ever make a makeup palette, this is exactly what it would look like. It would be literally all these colors. I would probably just stick an orange in there too because I like orange eyeshadow. Enchantress, this one is my favorite. It's my favorite for my nose as well. So I'm currently in the process of stretching my ears. I'm not vlogging it and it's not really a journey for me. So my ears are 26. Look, you can see the gap between my plug and my ear. They have naturally stretched over time. So it's literally just a case of popping the next size in. So that's what I'm doing. I have 26s in at the moment, which is what I have always had. I've ordered 27s, which I'm hoping will just slide in. I'm pretty sure they will. And then I'm gonna go to 28. My ultimate goal is to go to 30, hoping that that won't be too long, but it will be as long as it needs to be because your body, you can't rush a stretch. You can't rush these things. If you rush them, you get blowouts like me when I stretched when I was younger. Yeah, don't rush stretching, please, guys. Take your time. I haven't stretched my ears in about 8 years was the last time I stretched my ears, and they're only now ready to go up to the next size. I'm just piling the shadow on. I need an eyeshadow. I never use eyeshadow primer, and I want to start using it because I feel like this shade would pop so much if I used it. It wouldn't run out as much if I didn't stab it with my makeup brush every time I used it. What else? What else? What else? Oh, so it's my birthday. Next month, August, is my birthday, and we are going to Slam Dunk Festival. So Slam Dunk is just a one-day festival. Well, it's 2 days, but one in the north and one in the south, and we're going to the south one. I'm so excited for that, because I didn't think we were going to do anything for my birthday, because I don't really like to celebrate my birthday anymore. Corona's just kind of taken the fun out of everything for me. So it's nice that we're doing something. It's nice that it's that, because there's some awesome bands there, really like bands that I wanted to see when I was younger that I didn't get to see. NoFX, Alkaline Trio, I think Sum 41 are there, I can't remember. Ice Nine Kills, I really like Ice. I like Ice Nine Kills. I saw them when they supported Motionless a few years ago. And then I kind of forgot about them, and I forgot how much I liked them when I saw them play. YouTube recommended them a little while ago, and I was like, oh, this sounds familiar. And then I realized that I had seen them live and I really liked them and just forgot about them. Story of my life, that is. I will come back with this purple, so don't lose that brush. These are Spectrum brushes, by the way. I don't think I said that. Where's my other brush? They're really good. So I'm gonna go in with the black, which is called Sabbath. Get it? Black Sabbath. Get it? Get it? Get it? I'm gonna put that on my actual lids and blend it into that purple. So let's talk about some things that lockdown have made me realize, because it was a lot of reflection time for a lot of us. I learned that I have no patience, which I knew anyway. I have zero patience. I am just, I want something, I want it then, I want it there. And that's just really reinforced. I've learned that I am stronger than I think I am. Hey, yay! Trauma made us stronger. I think I said this in my last Get Ready With Me, which was filmed during like lockdown as well. I've been dealing with a lot of stuff that I had suppressed. I've kind of accepted it now. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm gonna give you a trigger warning. Oh, I don't put makeup in the corner of my eyes, by the way, because my eyes are really sensitive and they water. But I find it makes my eyes look a bit more like a chipmunk and I like it. So I've been dealing with the fact that when I was younger, I was groomed. It sounds so crazy, but I didn't realize. I'm a strong person. Almost blocked it out. And it wasn't until I was sat with Ben and I was thinking about Violet and she's like seven, well, she was six at the time. And it was like, she's only a few years younger than what I was. And I just, yeah. So I've been dealing with that. And I don't like to talk about my feelings, so appreciate that little snippet there because I won't talk about it again. Where's my eyeliner? Right in front of me. This liquid liner is the Deadly Sins Cosmetics liquid liner. It's my favourite. It glides on so smoothly. So I'm going to put this on the top of my Dula Matte Lip Wing and then on the bottom, because I don't go to the corner of my eye, I do like a little downward fluke. Little downward fluke. So yeah, I've been dealing with it a lot over lockdown. I feel like it was nature's way of forcing me to face my problems because I shut things away. I do not deal with my problems at all. I lock them in a tiny box and then I burn that box and I chuck the ashes into the ocean. So this bit, I kind of go down like this. There, see what I did there? See what I did? Look, looks like a little shark fin now. Yeah, but that's been really therapeutic for me to deal with everything. Like, I don't like to get emotional, but to have to be forced to deal with it has been really good, and it has allowed me to just move on from, oh, do you know what? It's a long story. I don't like talking about it. But I do have you guys to thank because you guys are like my therapy, and without you guys, like, I've got Ben. But I find it really hard to talk to people in real life about how I'm feeling. So when I'm doing shiz like this, I'm not talking to anyone. Look, I've just smudged it. I'm alone in my room, talking to my camera, but I am talking. So you guys are like my free therapist. So thanks for that. I appreciate it. Thanks for watching me f***ing up my face while I tell you about my f***ed up insides. Oh, that looks really cute. I'm surprised when my makeup looks cute. So back in with my NYX matte liquid liner. Ugh. Ugh. You have to make that noise, otherwise it doesn't stick. And I also go over my tattoo. There we go. Just to make it a little bit more prominent. Back in with my spectrum, ladies. Or is that speculum? Spectrum. Pendulum. Spectrum? You know what I mean. Back in with that thing, into my Enchantress eyeshadow, and then I go on the edge of my nose. I usually go further round, but because of my nose piercings, I've been doing it like just like this. Dab, 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 dab. And then very carefully do not get it in those piercings. I like to go underneath as well though. There we go. That's so cute. So I have been trying to, I realise that I'm about to contradict myself because I've just been saying that it's summer holidays, I can't edit, I can't film. The fact that it is now my job terrifies me, but in the best possible way. So it has been my full-time job. All right, let me pack my shiz away. Mascara. I always forget mascara. If you look at my videos, you probably notice I don't have mascara on because I always forget it. Great Lash, I don't know where this is from, I've had it for years, still haven't run out. But since it has been my job now for about 3 months, I am really, really enjoying it. It's so much fun. I love being my own boss. When my routine was to take Violet to school every day, and then when I come back, I sit down, I edit, I work. And it was really, really good until I started getting lazy and started having days off. I didn't have anyone to answer to. I didn't have to call in sick. I get call in sick anxiety. I had like 2 sick days when I worked at the pub, and I was there for like 6 years because the anxiety of calling up to phone in sick was so much worse than actually being sick. But I can just take a day off whenever I like now. And that's a big thing. So on that note, with me trying to take it, try. I gotta stop saying take it seriously, because I do take it seriously. I'm trying to work harder at it, maybe. Be less lazy. I want to do more collabs. I want to get my channel out there a bit more, because I swear when I'm in my chat, I've tried to stop it. I don't know if you know it, but I have tried to stop. YouTube doesn't really promote me, because I swear, and my content's rubbish, but we'll work on it. Trying to get better at it. I'm a piece of trash, and it's hard to be anything but a piece of trash when you are the trash. So what I'm basically saying is I really want to do more collabs with people. I want to, like, my piercing one was wasn't a collab, but I had a YouTuber Moose Ham in it. And it was so much fun, because when you do videos with other YouTubers, they understand that you have to film stuff, and they understand that, like, vlogs, this is a vlog example. So when I vlog with my friends, I'm always in the back of my, like, they're absolutely fine with it, but in the back of my mind I'm like, oh, they must think I'm such a loser. Like, every little 5 seconds I whack my camera out and just film something, film the sky because it looked pretty. But when you're with other YouTubers, it's like, oh, they're doing it too, and I really appreciate that. So I want to do more collabs with people, especially now that things, you know, we're allowed to travel a bit more now. Oh, something else I forgot to tell you. I forgot to write it down. I'll tell you in a second. So that's on my list kind of for this year, especially next year when things are hopefully really back to normal. I have so many people I want to ask. I've got Rowley I want to ask. And Luxeria, I'm just obsessed with Luxeria at the minute. It's unreal. I was thinking Toxic Tears, but I don't think she likes me. I don't know. I'm just gonna like focus and get out of my headspace and just, so hopefully more collabs will be on the cards. And before I forget, Ben and I, sorry, I'm gonna do my lipstick. So I use liquid eyeliner to do my lipstick, and I use Lip Safe liquid eyeliner. This is the Deadly Sins Cosmetics one. I've just said it's Lip Safe. I don't actually know if this is Lip Safe, but if I die, it'll say in my gravestone, she died from ingesting eyeliner. I just find it works and lasts so much better than lipstick. And it's what all the goths used to do in the 80s, so can't be that bad, right? But we might be going, fingers crossed, I don't know any details at the minute. We may be going to California next year. So Ben's sister lives in LA, so we are hopefully going to see her next year, because I don't think I'm ever going to be in America again. I would love to plan a meet up for America, for American people. I would love it. I know we're like 4 hours from Las Vegas when we go there, so I'm like, Ben, please, let's go to Las Vegas, please, please. I wanna go to the Slats. I wanna do Phoebe from Friends and find a lurker and do the Slats. I'm so excited for this potential journey. I've just gone over the edge of my lips. I'm gonna have really big lips for this. I may have to scrub that off and do that again. Yeah, so hopefully 2022 we'll be heading to California, and I'll have California vlogs. Dream of Californication. Hey, lips don't look too bad. She says to herself every morning as they in fact look bad. So we are nearly done. Got my hair, got my lips, got my top, and that's it. So I'm gonna do my shout outs. I have got all the shout outs for you beautiful, beautiful babes. This is Deadly Sins Cosmetics matte liquid lipstick in Nvidia. Discount code below. This is one of my favorite shades. I love to pair this with this eyes look, this nose look, this lip look. It's my favorite look. So let's start. Shout outs. Blend it in with the black with the stick, like just gently. So I go thick in the middle where there is no lipstick. Like that. There we go. So I need to say shout outs to my two newest patrons, Vinyl. Yeah, that's a real name. How amazing is that? And Jeno. Sorry, Jolie. Whenever I hear people's names, it always reminds me of a film that I hear it in, that I've heard it in. Jenny, I'm so sorry. But Jenny, whenever I hear Jenny, I think, oh God, please don't hate me, Jenny. I hear Forrest Gump. I love Forrest Gump. And I hear Forrest Gump. And I also have shout outs for Susanna and Georgia. I don't know any films with Susanna and Georgia. Let me think. I feel you. Oh, Oh, that's Joanna. That's not Susanna.
Susanna.
Oh, look, it doesn't match your name, and I got the lyrics wrong.
I suck.
We need to say something about Georgia's name. Isn't that a place in America? I'm from Macon, Georgia. It is. Sorry, Georgia. Sorry, everyone. I just like butchered your names. I'm gonna pop my really holy, very, very old, but Emily will not throw it away, wig cap on. But I get to show you my hair. So you ready? Ready? Plants versus zombies, scientist realness. I am obsessed with Plants versus Zombies at the minute, by the way, guys. Like beyond obsessed. I've been staying up to 1 o'clock in the morning playing it. Garden Warfare 2. Obsessed. That's how long my real hair is. I've been growing it, if you don't know what I'm talking about, I shaved my head January last year. I've been growing it back for a year and a half. I have not cut this at all. Ignore the front because I've cut it, I've dyed it, I've done everything to it. I shaved my fringe off because the last time I bleached it, it literally fell out. So I shaved it all off and that's how long it's grown. So you can see my roots. But for bloodstock, my fringe, I'm gonna have my green fringe and my black hair, so keep an eye out for that weirdo. Probably with a look like this, but a lot stinkier because I would have been in a tent for 5 days with no shower. Can't wait. I was really fighting the urge to shave my head during summer. It was like, we're still in summer, but it was so hot. I walked to school to pick my daughter up one day and I was like, I'm gonna shave my head as soon as I get home. I'm gonna just do it. I'm not gonna film it. I'm literally gonna go to my bathroom, pick up the shears, pretend I'm a sheep and shave myself. And I told Violet this on the way home and she went, no, don't do it. I like your hair. And then all of a sudden that rush of, I'm gonna shave my head, was gone. My daughter knows how to calm my impulses. And I'm glad I didn't because it's so long now and I'm so happy with it. Makeup done, I'm gonna change my top. Whoop! Before you ask, my top is very old Disturbia. I got it in a size too small and the nipple rings are too high, but their sizes are really weird. So if I got my size, it would have been too baggy and it wouldn't have looked how I wanted it to. So I might try and make my own version of this, where the nipples are in the correct places. And my collar, I think it's from Killstar. I got it from eBay, but it is one of my favorite collars. So I'm gonna pop my wig on, and then I am all done for my Get Ready With Me video for today. I haven't been wearing this much lately, actually. I've been wearing my green one pretty much every day because I've been feeling the green vibes, like just green hair. I did almost dye my real hair split the other day though, because I have a box of colour stripper in my bathroom and every time I go for a wee it looks at me, and right next to it is a box of bleach and I'm like, and there's a box of black hair dye there as well, and I'm just like, oh, I could just do my real hair split. It's such a first world problem, but wearing wigs in summer is really, really hot. Just because I cut my fringe, just because I shaved my fringe off. If I didn't shave my fringe off, I would just stick my extensions in and have my real hair. But nope. Like, I looked like my hair was receding. It was all long and mullet-y, and then the top was practically bald. Oh, that looks cute. I got my glasses on. I always say it looks cute, and then I put my glasses on, and then I'm like, oh, I see what you did there. All right, I hate this lipstick so much. I've just gone over the edge. I'm gonna have to fix that, excuse me. I'm just gonna have to fix my lipstick. Okay, that's slightly better, slightly less, oh, it's a little bit in the corner. Do you know what? See, once I notice one problem, I notice loads, and I have to fix that, and oh, now the other side's not even. Leave it alone! So that's it, I'm done. I should be going, oh, I've got something stabbing my ass. It's usually a good thing, but not right now. It hurt. I was hoping this was a going out get ready with me, but it's a staying in and filming YouTube videos get ready with me. Let's puff this hair up. Let's puff it up, love. Puff it up. So I'm now gonna go and film another video. I don't know what. I've got a list on my phone. I'm gonna see like, oh, fancy that one today. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed all my little updates. I don't think I've got anything else. Manchester will definitely be moving, as well as the Nottingham meet and the London meet. We're just gonna, it's just not practical at the moment to get people to come out and hang out, especially from all around the UK. So keep an eye out. We'll wait for things to get safer and then we will have the biggest night out ever. I'll see you guys at Bloodstock Thursday, 1 o'clock. Then we have the meet. I'll put the link in the description below. But that's it. Thank you guys. I'll see you very soon. Take care. Much love. Most of all, stay weird.